Hello, I am SquidofLove. Welcome back. Star Citizen's presentation in this year's Gamescom has been absolutely phenomenal and left us all dreaming of how great this game is going to be, not when it will be released, but even before that, when the Alpha 3.0 will become available to all of us, hopefully before the end of this year. With the Alpha 3.0, the creation of a living, breathing universe will slowly start taking shape, since we will have access to the full Stanton system with a great number of new locations to visit and explore. And although a bigger universe will have a significant impact on our experience and enjoyment, the existence of well-written and meaningful missions is what will give shape to the history and lore of the Star Citizen universe and make all the difference. So let's go ahead and talk about the evolution of missions with Alpha 3.0 and what we should be expecting. The missions that are available to us right now in the persistent universe are quite simple. They are asking us to go to a certain location, perform a task, then return, rinse and repeat. Obviously, these missions will not disappear with the coming of Alpha 3.0, but other, more complex missions will make their appearance and the life in the persistent universe a lot more interesting. In this year's presentation, we have seen an NPC conducting the character and offering him a contract, actually offering him the choice to accept a mission. And this is exactly what will change the system behind missions: the introduction of NPC and the evolution of the subsumption AI system. With Alpha 3.0, the first NPC will make their appearance in the persistent universe around the various locations of the Stanton system, and this NPC will be the population of the Stanton system. And wherever there is population, there are needs to be covered. As we have already mentioned before, this NPC at the beginning will be quite simple. They will have a diversity and variety of actions. They will be following a certain schedule depending on their personality, on their profession, and of course the location they reside. But their actions will be simple, they will not be very talkative, and the missions that will be offering will not be that complex. But as the subsumption system will evolve, they will start evolving as well. They will be able to perform more complex conversations, they will start having more complex needs, and they will start offering us more complex and more interesting missions. The interaction we have with this NPC will depend on a lot of things, like we have said before, will depend on their profession, what kind of job they are doing. If they are shopkeepers, they will probably ask us to buy something from them, they will probably ask us to get them more products so they can sell them in the market. If they are smugglers, they will ask us to smuggle something. If they are traders, they will ask us to help them protect their cargo or help them transport something from point A to point B. Of course, that's not the only factor that will affect our interaction with them. Our reputation will also play an important role on which characters, which NPC will get to contact us, which NPC will offer us certain missions. If we are law-abiding citizens hunting down pirates or criminals, then probably NPC from security organizations will contact us in order to help them bring down some notorious criminals or pirates. If we are not that lawful, if we are known smugglers, then someone that needs something brought to him in secrecy might contact us and offer us a very nice reward for our services. Our personal history with a certain NPC and our interaction with them will also determine if we will be getting a new mission or not. Something else that could make NPC offer us missions later when they will be more talkative and more evolved, it will be our conversation with them, how the flow of conversation is going, and if they are happy with what we're saying to them, if they are happy with not only our reputation, but also their impressions of us during our little chat. Something else that will affect the offering and the complexity of the new missions in the persistent universe is the introduction of the first professions. Trading and cargo transport around the various locations of the persistent universe will give the opportunity to the game to produce economy-driven missions. So, for example, if there is a need to a certain location for a certain product, a mission will be generated asking players to deliver a certain amount of that product to that location. If there is an emergency on a certain location and there is a need of medical supplies, then again the game will generate another mission asking for players to deliver these medical supplies to that other location. These new economy-driven missions might be directly related with trading and cargo transport, but in reality, they will create opportunities for other players as well. For example, pirates will be able to hunt down traders that are delivering the needed products to a certain location and make a profit like this. Bounty hunters will be able to go after pirates in order to protect traders and their cargo, and of course mercenaries will have the opportunity to find a job protecting traders, delivering the much needed products, the much needed goods to their destination. This is a very good example of how complex the mission system will be in the persistent universe, of how connected each activity will be with the others. A rising demand of a certain product in a certain location will not only attract traders to that location, but also pirates, bounty hunters, mercenaries, and general other players that will want to pursue their own goals. And this is exactly what will make NPC belonging to different organizations to start generating missions that will be directed to players with different interests in order to perform a task, in order to fulfill a certain need. Either that is the transportation of a certain good, or the stealing of these certain goods, or the protection of a certain area. Let's not also forget that eventually service beacons will become available in the game, and in that way players themselves will be able to offer and request assistance. In that way players will be able to create their own missions and offer them to other players. This new system, the system of service beacons, will definitely take the mission system one level further, and although there might be some risk sometimes accepting requests from other players, it will definitely make the persistent universe a lot more alive. The most impressive part of this year's presentation was definitely the part where the character entered a destroyed starfare in order to search for its black box. This was also a first look in exploration salvaging content, and although these professions will not be amongst the first professions that will make their appearance in the persistent universe, it is definitely something that will change missions, that will increase the complexity of missions being offered in the persistent universe when they will be available. It shows how searching destroyed derelict ships or abandoned stations around the persistent universe will connect different gameplay with each other, will connect different activities with each other. So for example, if we have accepted a mission to search for the black box of a destroyed ship, we could also combine it with some exploration gameplay or some exploration missions depending on what we will see in the future. Another fine example of this is if we have accepted a mission to search for a certain item on a destroyed vessel, and at the same time we have accepted a salvaging mission to deliver back a certain amount of scrap. In that way, we can go to the derelict ship, to the destroyed vessel, search for the item, and at the same time perform some salvaging, bring back the required amount of scrap and the item at the same time, increasing our effectiveness, increasing our reward. Something worth mentioning from this year's presentation is the fact that when the character completed the first mission, the NPC contacted him again, offering him an additional mission. This is going to be very interesting. I really hope this will be with the first implementation of the mission system, the mission 1.0 system that will come with Alpha 3.0, and different missions, depending on the scenario, will be able to generate additional tasks, additional missions that we get to choose if we want to follow or not. When this will be implemented in the persistent universe, then it will definitely make the mission system in Star Citizen the best we have seen in a similar game so far. Let's not also forget that with the Alpha 3.0 we will have access and we will be able to land everywhere we want on the planets and moons of the Stanton system. That means that missions we accept on settlements will probably send us not only to space but also on a certain location on the surface of the planet. What I would really love to see is missions being generated from planetary exploration. If we are performing exploration on a planet, moving around, sightseeing if you want, and we happen to find a crash ship, it will be amazing if that crash ship will generate a mission asking us to go to another location in order to find a certain item, the owner maybe of this crash ship, and gain a reward. The potential of the mission system is absolutely amazing. It will make the persistent universe a lot more alive, and it will also give us a much better and unique experience. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. I am SquidofLove, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.